STG Repairs has served our customers since 2008 in Miami. STG Repairs team fixes almost all smartphones, tablets, and computers on the market. It also specializes in board-level repairs. Troubleshoot board-level problems. No touchscreen function, no backlight, no power. Replace knocked-off SMD components on any board. Problems with water and other liquid damage, and charging problems. We also do factory unlock, software errors, data transfer, and recovery. We have a very solid reputation in the repair community. Our clients can count on our experience. Our goal is reliable service and competitive prices.
Okay, right now we are going to replace the connector, the charger connector for iPad mini that someone has tried to do it already. Okay, they did it in another store. Vamos a trabajar un iPad mini que ya trataron de hacerlo en otra tienda. Vamos a ver qué nos encontramos. Está levantada. Vamos a ver si podemos pasar. Okay. Como pueden ver, you can see this, somebody has already tried to work on this, and this is almost, as you can see, there's some pads that they are not soldered. Okay, let me try this scar. First thing now we're gonna do is we are going to add some flux. Hopefully they didn't break the pads. Vamos a esperar que ellos no hayan roto las pistas. Ok. Pueden ver ahí, sí. Aplicamos bastante soldadura. Y vamos, as you see, I applied a lot of solder, and now just going to put it on top like this. Oh, perfect. Apparently nothing happened to the connector. Let me see. Let me Now we're going to clean it. Vamos a limpiar. And you can see this is now clean. This is the new connector. Okay. Okay. Yeah. So going to be like this. Going to add a flux. Let me use this other flux. Vamos a usar este otro flux. Como ven, ya tengo soldadura todas las pistas. Y ahora vamos a soldar el conector. Okay. Let me change. This one, and drop the temperature. Now we are going to solder the flex. Vamos a soldar el flex y vamos a buscar, lo que queremos encontrar son los dos puntitos dorados, que es lo que nos indica que va en su lugar. Este de aquí. Que la luz no me deja ver claramente. Now you can see there and you can see on the bottom. It was there. Okay. It is there now. Okay. Gonna touch one corner right there. Oops, oops, oops. And then we are going to apply flux. This corner. Okay. Now we're going to apply flux on the whole FPC, in the whole connector. Let me see. So you can see that. Now you can see better. And we are going to just add more solder. Okay, perfect. We just clean it with alcohol. Lo limpiamos con alcohol. Y ya está listo. Ya está listo. Vamos a probar lo que funcione. Antes vamos a ponerle... Vamos a cubrir con Captain Tape. Just going to cover. This is not necessary, I just do it because it's going to look better and it's going to protect the contacts. Esto no es necesario. Lo voy a hacer más que todo, o sea, lo hago más que todo porque protege los contactos y también luce mejor. Como pueden observar, así queda. Vamos a ver si ahora funciona. Vamos a ver si funciona. Let me change the camera so you can see this is going to work. Okay. Just going to connect the power flex. The digitize. All this through here and here. Remember this iPad. Somebody tried before. Someone tried before. Por eso está iPad. Alguien trató antes. Entonces, vamos a ver si ahora. Logramos resolver el problema. Okay, let me test the battery. Vamos a medir la batería. A ver qué voltaje tiene. Let me show you here. Okay. Now this is going to be impossible to. Let me change this camera so you can see. Now you are going to see that it's not going to be possible to the battery is completely dead. So you can see it's 2.87. At least we need 3.7. Okay. So now we're gonna have to charge the battery in order to make this iPad work. Maybe this was the first issue and by mistake they tried to replace the connector and the only problem was the battery, maybe. Como vieron, la batería solamente tiene 83 o 87, no me acuerdo exactamente, creo que es 87. Vamos a ver, vamos a volvérselo a hacer a ustedes en español. .87 y el mínimo que necesitamos para que esta tableta arranque serían 3.7. Probablemente ese era el único problema que esta tableta tenía y cuando la vieron erróneamente fueron directamente a cambiarle el charging port, cuando tal vez el único problema que tenía era que la batería había bajado totalmente. Ok, entonces con esto nos despedimos. Thank you for watching our video. If you like the video, please give us a like. If not, just give us a comment, please. Si le gustó el video, denos un like y si no, denos un comentario. Gracias.